Hello, good morning, friends. This is Arvind Pal Singh here. So in the continuation of our session for the finance for non-finance professionals, so the intention behind this series is to provide some useful information or tips or bites to people who are in the non-finance professionals, in the non-finance professions. So basically all doctors, lawyers, architects, engineers who feel, you know, they don't understand these basic terms. So our CMMM, Jyotsna Rajpal, she's here to help us. We thank you from the bottom of our heart for your presence here and to give us all the learning. So without much of taking your time, I request Mrs. Rajpal to take over the session and provide us the next learning today. All to you, ma'am.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you, Arvind.
Yeah,
friends, we are today in the fourth session. Till now, what we have discussed is like right from transaction till the sketching of balance sheet, we have already seen what all points to be considered, what all things to be seen, and what all precautions to be taken. Today, we will go ahead with another very crucial statement, that is cash flow statement. If I talk about the statutory requirement, yes, once in a year, we need to prepare our cash flow statement and attach it to our audited accounts. But if I see the significance of cash flow statement from our daily routines, I feel everyone should have a daily cash flow. If we are having a daily cash flow, then we will definitely be able to control all our finances very well. Maybe business, maybe home, maybe personal. You must have heard of Marwadi way of working. Though it sounds very odd to talk about it, but I find that as far as cash flow is concerned, you will never find a Marwadi person to be cash strapped, because they are maintaining their daily purta register or their daily purta book. What is it? It is nothing but whatever they have received and whatever they have spent during the day, they maintain in that very book or that very ledger or that very bahi, whatever you call it. So that's why they are never in cash crunch. They are always surplus. And they are able to utilize their resources to the best. So this cash flow statement, this is the practical aspect. Rather, I can say from the ancient age-old traditions, this cash flow was in practice. Then as far as statutory requirement is concerned, we are required to make it once a year along with our audited statement. But now let's come to the practicality of the things. How it is prepared, why it is prepared, and what all things to be like accounted for when we are preparing this cash flow statement. This is a final statement we are preparing out of our own records. First of all, next slide, please. Next slide, please. Yeah. What is cash flow statement? It is basically statement showing the changes and movements relating to cash and cash equivalents. Now, what are cash equivalents? Cash equivalents are checks, bills of exchange, etc. But nowadays, it is almost cash and bank balance. Or else you can say, presently, we have cash stuck in many apps. Like I have Paytm app, I have Google Pay app, I have, say, Airtel app, I have Vodafone app. So in all these apps, we are putting some money, say 100, 200, 500 rupees in every place we are keeping so that we can use. So these are all cash equivalents of the present day time. If you are ignoring them while preparing cash flow, you are totally mistaken. So whatever cash is in your hand, whatever cash is lying in the bank, and whatever cash places yeah, you have parked, that is all considered here. Then it reveals and analyzes the impact of changes in income and balance sheet. Now, what does it mean? You know what is income, you know what is balance sheet. Now, what additional it is going to tell you, that how it will change, tell you the impact of changes in income. Like how income as like how income has got converted into profit. You know, every income is not profit. You know, I think by now you must be understanding the difference between income and profit. Income is all your gross receipts. Profit is whatever you have saved out after paying all your expenditures, after incurring all your expenditures. And what is balance sheet? Balance sheet is a state of affairs as on a particular day. So here what we have to consider, we have to see the whatever is the exact income in hand on which my tax is payable. And balance sheet means how the things have moved in the balance sheet. We will just go to the old illustrations and then understand this very point. But we have to understand that changes in the balance sheet over two periods, like last year or last month or last day or last week, whatever was my balance sheet and what is my balance sheet today. So what is the difference between these two balance sheets will definitely impact our cash flow. How it will impact, we will just see. Then there are three activities through which cash can be generated or through which cash can be spent. Like operating activities means our routine operations, like I'm into the sale and purchase of, say, grocery, then that is my operating activity. Then financing activity, like from where I have procured some money to be invested in the business. I have utilized my own capital to be invested in the business. And through that financing activities, there are certain things like I have to pay some interest. I will receive some interest if I have invested somewhere else. Then investing activities. So these three activities are crucial for preparing the cash flow. Like our entire receipts and payments, we will segregate into three parts. One is operations, another is financing, and another is investing. Okay, next slide, please. Yeah. Cash flow, operations, investing, and financing. Operations are nothing but whatever things we have considered while preparing our profit and loss account. Most of the things will come from there, and a part of operations, operational income or operational cash flow will come from your balance sheet also. So we will just see in detail. Then financing activities, that is purely a balance sheet extract or balance sheet items. And then investing activities is also part of balance sheet items. You can go move ahead to the next slide. Yeah. Here is the format for cash flow. This is the routine business format. First of all, we will take cash flow from operating activities. Now, what are the operating activities? The crux of our profit and loss account is our profit before tax and extraordinary items. While studying the profit and loss account, you must be remembering that we had calculated profit before tax. So this profit before tax is a very crucial item in our P&L. We take directly that figure here. Then there was an item in the profit and loss account that was depreciation. All of us know depreciation. It is our charge towards the wear and tear of our fixed assets. So depreciation is an item which does not involve any cash outflow. Please always remember that it is only an accounting adjustment. It is not requiring any cash to go out. No cash is going out of the business. Cash will go only after a span of 10 years or 15 years, whenever you want to replace that machine or whenever you want to increase the capacity of that machine. At that time, your cash flow will get affected. But every year, cash flow doesn't get affected by depreciation account. So whenever we are charging depreciation to our profit and loss account, cash flow will not get affected. So what we will do? Profit before tax was the total cash which was coming to our business. We have taken that. Then we have added back the depreciation, because depreciation is such an amount which was reduced from our profit before tax, but it does not require any cash outflow. So our cash to that extent has not gone out. So we have simply added back that depreciation amount. Then comes adjustment for interest. Interest is not considered as operational operating activity because it is considered as whatever interest we are paying to finance something. Suppose I have financed my fixed assets. So that amount of interest should go to the financing activity. It will not be part of the operating activity. So we have taken out interest also from the our operational profit and loss account, our profit before tax. So we will add back that interest also in the profit before tax. Then comes income from interest. Income from interest is and income from dividend. These are two incomes, but these have accrued to us not because of any operational activity. These have accrued to us because of some investments made. So these two components will also go to the cash flow related to the investing activity. Right? I think it must be clear. If there's any doubt, we will just clear in the doubt clearing session. Then total cash flow from the operating activities is what? Profit before tax plus depreciation plus interest minus income from interest and minus dividend from it. Dividend income. So it is 3740. Then comes another part of operations which is coming from the balance sheet. Like in while studying the balance sheet, what did we study? We studied that there is a working capital like current assets and current liabilities. So, Arvind, can we go back to slide number, say, 30, 28, 29 balance sheet in the last? No, 28. Slide number 28. Yeah. Yes, correct. So, what do we see here? We see the 2-year figures here. 2 years figures are there. And here, very clearly, we can have the movement in our assets and liabilities. Like, please go to the next slide. Then we will come back to this slide again. Yeah. So here you see all current assets, like inventories are there, receivables are there. Loans and advances, cash and bank balances. We will leave cash and bank balances, but rest other current assets we will consider. So you see there is a change between year 1819 to 1920. So whatever is the difference between these 2 years figures will become part of the cash flow. Correct? Please note this line. Remember this statement. Whatever changes over a period of year or over a period of time, it can be month, it can be week, it can be day. Over a period of time, whatever is the change in our current assets and current liabilities will form part of the cash flow. It will not be, it is not only the part of balance sheet, they also affect our cash flow. How come? Like last year, I had 112 lakh of rupees as inventories. This year, I have 120 lakh of inventories. What does it simply mean? That 8 point something lakh of additional amount I have invested in my inventories. Means my cash to that extent has gone down. Then receivables. We had last year, we have receivable of 59.25 lakhs. This year, I have 63.10 lakhs. So whatever is the difference amount is my cash gone out of the business to finance the increase in these current assets. I hope it's clear. Then, Arvind, please go back to the earlier slide. Just one slide before. Yeah. Here you see the item current liabilities, item number 3. So, here you have trade creditors, provisions and other current liabilities. So, right from 87 lakh of rupees to 90 lakh of rupees means to buy 3 lakh of rupees, my liabilities have gone out, gone up. Means the cash which I should have, if the cash to that extent of 3 lakh rupees has not gone out of the business, it has stood up in the business in the form of current liabilities. So this has also acted as the financing of my operations. So now we can come back to our original slide, number 35. Yeah. So here what we are going to take, decrease in inventories. In this case, figures I have not taken as it is. Decrease in inventories in this case is 1050. Means inventories have gone down in this case. Means I could sell my stock which I had in the last year. The stocks which I was holding in the beginning of this year were sold off during the year, and my current my inventories have gone down by 1050. So this amount has liquidated, that stock has liquidated, and that has been added to the cash. So we have simply added that in the cash. Then we say increase in receivables, means my debtors, my receivables have gone up from say 500 rupees to 1000 rupees. So 500 was the amount which I should have received. Had that been at the same level, means I should have received that cash to that extent of 500 lakhs. But that has not come to me. It simply means that my cash is diverted to that extent of 500 rupees in case of to finance the increase in receivables. So wherever there is increase in our current assets, it will be shown as minus. You have to simply apply the common sense. You have not to remember anything. You have not to cram anything. You have to simply understand whether your cash has gone out of the business or your cash has remained in the business or it has come in the business. Similarly, decrease in payables. Decrease in payables means, like your creditors have come down, means you have paid back to your creditors. To that extent. So all these plus minus will come to the cash generated from the operating activities. Then you have to reduce the income tax paid, because income tax as it is, we will be paying out of the cash or cash equivalents. So it will be like to that extent, it will be reduced. My cash will be reduced from that amount by that amount. So my net cash generated from the operating activities is 1690 rupees. The next slide, please. Cash flow from investing activities, as I have told you earlier, that whatever dividend or interest received in the first earlier slide, we have reduced that 500 rupees that will be added back here in the cash, because ultimately that cash has come into the business, but that was not from operations, that was from the investing activities. So we will add that cash in our cash flow in the investing activities. And sale of fixed assets and investments. 20 lakh of rupees we have, worth 20 lakh of rupees, we have sold the fixed assets. So that cash also has come into the business. Then we have purchased assets, fixed assets and investment worth rupees 350 lakhs. So that will be the cash gone out. So my total cash inflow from investing activity is around 170 lakh rupees. Then comes my cash flow from financing activities, means proceeds from borrowings, equity, means whatever money I have received from the equity or I have borrowed from bank, from debentures, from market, ICD, wagera, wagera, what all. So that will be all considered here. Then repayment of the borrowings. If I have taken some loan and repaid some more loan, so that repayment of borrowings will be reflected here. Then payment of interest. The interest which we have reduced from the operating activities will directly be reduced from here, because there we have added back, here we will reduce it. Then comes payment of dividend. If you have paid dividend to your equity holders, that will also be coming here, not in the operational activities, because that was ultimately to service your financing. To debt service or to your equity service. So that will be added in your, that will be reduced from your cash flow from the financing activities. So here you see the cash flow generated is 1380, means I have negative cash flow from the financing activities. Let's come back to come to the next slide. Now these A, B and C means cash from operating activities, cash from our financing activities and cash from investing activities. all three together will be added. So my net cash generation for that particular period is 1480. I will add cash balance of the opening, like from day one, wherever I am just doing the calculations, usually 1st April. So my cash balance at that time was this much. So closing cash balance is this, 1670. And this cash balance should tally with your cash and cash equivalents shown in the balance sheet. So that is the check of cross check of balance sheet as well as the cash flow statement. And here you have to always remember one thing, that cash flow is cash inflow is always equal to the cash outflow. So it cannot be otherwise. Next slide, please. Now, what are the inferences? This is very important. That number one, profit and loss and balance sheet, both are considered for working out the cash flow statement. Like initially we saw that vouchers, this, that. So the ultimate impact of voucher can be seen in the cash flow statement. Cash flow statement is very important because it shows the liquidity of the business. It shows that how much actually we are, how much actually cash is coming in from the business or going out from the business. And it also shows that how much funds have come to the business and from what sources it has come.
Whether ma'am, your voice is breaking.
Okay. Is it okay now? I don't see any reason because... Is it okay now? Hello? Hello?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, okay. So
actually, it's only 5 minutes left. I think we should wrap up in next 1 minute. Then we can open it for the questions.
Yeah. I'll just come to this. Then comes by controlling cash, one can control most of the business. Next. Yeah, my point is most of the business, it is not the 100% business. How to, now question comes in your mind that how to control complete business. Complete business can be controlled by operating your, controlling your operations as well as your cash. Like say your 70-80% you can control through your cash, but 20% you have to exercise through your operations. Next slide, please. Yeah. So what we call key performance indicators, are very crucial indicators which help you to control your business. What are those indicators? Number one, these are very industry specific, like cash flow, fund flow, profit and loss account. This is all. It is everywhere in every business across the globe. But key performance indicators are very specific to the industry. They are both like non-financial indicators also, like financial indicators also. What are non-financial indicators? Like in case of hotel industry, it may be like room occupancy. In case of airlines, it can be the passenger load factor. In case of manufacturing industry, it can be the capacity utilization. In case of architectural firms, consultancies, it can be the projects infused or project executed. So these are all non-financial parameters, and then financial parameters as we have already discussed. Next, please. So we have to move ahead. We have always to go ahead in search of new things. And what else, how we can improve our system by evaluating our own key performance indicators. So this is all from my side. Over to Arvind.
Thank you very much. That was very good refresher. Thank you very much for all the friends for attending this session. So I would like to mention a few things. You know what? First of all, any questions, please put up in the WhatsApp group. So our trainer can answer those questions in the WhatsApp group there. We got only 2 minutes right now. And I just wanted to share with you what is going on in our mind for the next sessions. We intend to continue to impart this knowledge about the finance accounting to all the professionals. At the same time, we are interested to start some specialized training for the focus groups. let's say, you know, I don't know, whatever focus groups you can have, maybe for the lawyers or doctors, you think that, you know, there are some particular topics you want more information on. So we would like to identify those kind of focus groups and tailor our training program for those people only. Having said that, that doesn't mean that, at this moment, I will say that we will continue this session for all the people, but at the same time, we would like to come up with some focus groups according to the participation in the WhatsApp. So please put your inputs there so that we know exactly what you want. Then accordingly, we can move ahead. And with this, I stop this session. Thank you very much for your time. And please put your questions in the WhatsApp group itself. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye.
Okay, thank you.